Super Series Muay Thai clash. Outside kicking and head kick early on from Sergio Wilson. He will waste no time. He's going to try and catch Rodtang cold here. And there's Rodtang. A left hook and a straight right hand, followed by a front kick to the midsection.
You can definitely see that Sergio Wilson knows the atmosphere of the ONE Championship, but he also understands the rule set. So he's coming on a lot faster than normal.
Rodtang, renowned in Thailand for not taking a backward step, always coming forward. A dropping knee from Wilson. A counter left hand there from the tank, Rodtang.
Wilson lands a nice little uppercut then, but he got caught flying in with an uppercut. Beautifully done by Rodtang.
Let's see if Rodtang gets on the inside. Starts going to the liver, starts going to the solar plexus, starts going to the spleen of Wilson. Wilson goes to the inside leg. Front kick again from Rodtang. This one opening at a cracking pace. A Muay Thai match in the ONE Super Series. Outside leg kick from Wilson. Suriname has produced so many great kickboxers over the years. The likes of Tyrone Spong, Remy Bunjaski, Melvin Manoff, Ernesto Hoost. And here we have Sergio Wilson.
That battle between the Netherlands and Thailand continues here at ONE Super Series.
Looking for a dump there maybe. Rodtang threads the left hand nicely. Rodtang outside thigh kick, then a front kick to the midsection, uppercut. Went higher than my cholesterol. Left hook, right hand there from Rodtang. A high run roundhouse. And just gets upended. 1 minute 25 remained. No feeling out process here in the opening round. They clinch up now. A chance for the knees. A chance for the elbow. And referee Onari breaks them.
Go!
I like how Rodtang utilizes that uppercut. It's a beautiful cutting uppercut, especially because Wilson's got a little bit of a height advantage on it. Beautifully throws that kick to the side, attacks the body.
Oh, what a dump! What a dump there from Rodtang! My word! The way he pivoted and wrenched Wilson to the canvas, and there's the tough thumping right hand. Here's the power from Rodtang.
Knees buckle, no knockdown there. Can Sergio survive the round? Here comes Rodtang again.
Amazing scene here in Jakarta. Rodtang absolutely unloading on Wilson. Touch gloves and we're underway. And Wilson comes out aggressively. Two-punch combination and a front kick. There's another front kick from the Dutchman. And here comes Rodtang. They want to go toe-to-toe now. Rodtang comes forward, thrust out the jab. There's a right hand. Cutting side kicks from Rodtang, chasing Wilson across the cage. Wilson throws a hook and a straight punch.
Wilson's still a bit wobbly. He doesn't have his legs completely under him. Beautiful push kick, caught him coming in.
Through an elbow there, Rodtang. There's the left hook. Wilson's gonna get off the cage. And Rodtang tries the elbow again.
Oh man, these punches coming from Rodtang, they sound like a bag full of hammers. They are getting thrown with some serious speed.
But Sergio's still here. He's not gonna go quietly into the night. He's not gonna wave the white flag. And there's another excellence of execution. A beautifully tight teep to the midsection from Rodtang.
You can see, and what's caught him off balance is that Sergio is in mid-attack. As he's getting these push kicks down, it's thrown off his balance completely.
Rodtang with more kick than a chorus line. Here in the second round, there's a front kick from Wilson. Throws one off the left leg, and Rodtang comes forward again. Turning back kick, looking for the liver. Looking to impact that Vegas nerve, and close down the body of the Thai.
But how tough is Sergio Wilson to stand there toe-to-toe with Rodtang?
Wilson went for the uppercut elbow. Good evasion, he leaned back like Fat Joe. A front kick to the midsection. A front side kick to the midsection from Rodtang.
This one is crazy. This one is awesome. It's one Super Series Muay Thai.
Now look at Rodtang stalking down Wilson.
Stalking. He's trying to roll through him like a tank, always coming forward. There's no backing up on Rodtang.
Look at him, nowhere. Just consistently moving forward. That's what's different about the cage, Michael. There's no corner to back your opponent into. It's a circle. You can continually run around, and that's what's giving Sergio Wilson a little bit of time in this one.
Amazing scene here in Jakarta for this Muay Thai match. Rodtang with the kicks again off the lead leg. Sergio spinning back fist and just upends himself. 40 seconds remaining, second round of three.
I swear, Rodtang just winked at you, Michael.
They clinch up dead center of the cage. Rodtang breaks off and chops the elbows. He comes forward now. Sergio uppercut elbow, and Rodtang chases him. There's an elbow from the Thai. There's an elbow from the Surinamese. And Rodtang just dumped him to the canvas. 15 seconds on the clock. This has been an absolute grit snorter. Rodtang again with the power laden left hand. There's the hook. Smack bang. How is Wilson standing? A spinning back elbow and a counter elbow from Wilson. A right hand to the kisser. Rodtang with the roundhouse kick. Looks for the clinch, and there's the end of the round.
He's got to be behind on every single judge's scorecard.
Third and final round, one Super Series Muay Thai match. A high right roundhouse kick there from Sergio Wilson. Backs him up with a left hand out of southpaw stance. There's a wild hooking right from Wilson. He's opened up like a house on fire. Overhand elbow from Rodtang.
He's marching forward. There's no fear in his eyes. He's continually pushing forward, challenging Rodtang to throw down with him.
Have you ever seen a walk forward style like Rodtang has shown us tonight? He doesn't take a backward step. He doesn't know how to go in reverse.
Man, you can just see the swagger just oozing out of Rodtang. Just the confidence and belief in himself.
Straight right hand, then a short right elbow. Smack bang on the kisser. Gives the beard a shave of Sergio Wilson. Wilson now at the knees, and Rodtang just ragdolls him and dumps him to the canvas.
Look at him just staring him down, begging him to get up so he can take more of this beating.
Sergio sticks out a stiff jab. That was nicely done. Rodtang goes for the headache maker. There's the uppercut elbow. A wild hook again from Rodtang. He's had more hooks than a Pirates convention. He comes forward again. Overhand right there from Sergio Wilson. Rides the head kick, covers up with a forearm. Rodtang catching right hand, but only a slip, says referee Onari. No count on Wilson. Picks himself back up. 1 minute 30 remains.
Wilson's continually trying to push forward, but look at this push kick. The timing is beautiful on it. Every single time Wilson enters that range, boom, the push kick's right there.
Again. Beautifully done from Rodtang. Keeps Wilson at bay. What has Sergio Wilson got left in his bag of tricks? This cerebral Muay Thai athlete from the Netherlands. And Rodtang comes forward. Sergio thrust out the left hand. They tango back against the cage. No knees thrown. And referee Onari breaks them. Under a minute remaining now. Right hand from Rodtang. They clinch up another dump from the tie. That is Muay Thai 101. And once again, Wilson's got to pick himself up off the floor.
Go!
Let's see if Rodtang goes back to the liver. Dips the right hand to the bread basket. Forces Wilson back against the cage. And Wilson comes forward. What guts, what tenacity here from the multi-world champion, Sergio Wilson. How many shots to the body has he taken from those kicks? There's one to the liver. There's one to the solar plexus. Sergio Wilson looks spent here. The final 15 seconds. He slapped him to the side of the head. It's a second knockdown from Rodtang.
Six, seven.
That left hand has been superb.
You said what makes Rodtang so tough, what makes him so hard to deal with, you said it was his body shots. And that is what is breaking Sergio Wilson. Look at these push kicks continually going after the body over and over again. And Sergio Wilson just looks dejected.
Rodtang is a Muay Thai monster. The hype proves real at one Super Series. And look at the respect. Look at the integrity, the martial arts code. But there's no doubt about this one. That young man, now signed to one Super Series, shows why. He is quite simply the hottest Muay Thai talent in the world right now.
The whole show was about Rodtang. Look at this. Beautifully done. He faked the push kick, but still landed it on the second attempt. That was picture perfect. And he was sliding in with attacks over and over again. The push kicks were beautifully done in the third round. But what they were doing is they were setting up so many other attacks. He was utilizing beautiful push kicks to punch combinations. And then he goes after the body. Look at that. Body, head, head, kick to the body. Beautifully done. The hype train is real behind Rodtang.
All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Rodtang Chinwagyo.
Buddy Khalid, a six-time Tunisian champion. Outside leg kicking a high kick early on from Khalid. How will the eight-week camp be for Rodtang Chinwagyo? 8 weeks between contests. Good evasion there from Rodtang. Early quick start here from Khalid, stringing together some combinations with the hands and the legs, Mitch.
Khalid's utilizing those push kicks very well. He's connected on multiple push kicks. He's finding range with his strikes. He can't stand in front of Rodtang, though. He's got...
Rodtang comes forward, the human tank, the wrecking ball. He's lining up the right, there's the left roundhouse kick. Rodtang fires the right hand down the tube, and Buddy Khalid ties him up. They tango back against the cage, a chance for the knees, and referee O'Leary breaks them. Rodtang has staggered the Tunisian kickboxing champion once already. Thought about the right hand, did Khalid. Ties him up. Nice snake here, the hands around the back of the head, and a dunk there from the two-time world champion, Rodtang Chinwagyo. Overhand right from Khalid, looping left hand. Rodtang dunks him again like yesterday's Garvey. And look at Rodtang saying, come on, bring it! What have you got? Here comes Rodtang!
Again, screaming at him.
This monster, look at this battle tank, this battle axe, this wrecking ball. There's the right hand from Rodtang.
You can see the experience advantage. Khalid has 41 total matches. Rodtang has 41 losses in his 300-match career.
Catches the kicking leg, Rodtang. Continually on the front foot here. Catches it again. And Khalid gets twisted and discombobulated. 40 seconds remains, first round. It's Rodtang's round. Front kick from the tie for the two-time world champion. Gloves up high on Rodtang. He doesn't want anything unexpected coming to the jaw from the swinging punches of Buddy Khalid.
4 ounce gloves, he has that opportunity. One touch on the chin, and that's it. It would connect there off the kick.
The roundhouse kick off the left there from Rodtang. The oohs, the ahs, the gnashing of teeth. This electrified crowd here in Manila. And Rodtang comes forward. A downward elbow from Khalid. Snaps the jab, there's a Tunisian. Rodtang misses with a roundhouse kick. A high check from the tie. Toe to toe now. Spinning back fist. Rodtang picks him off of the battle universe. And Rodtang comes out jabbing. Fighting Khalid. High right roundhouse. High left roundhouse. Good sticky right hand from the Tunisian.
He's got to move. He's got to keep that volume high. He can't stand there and let Rodtang tee off on him. He's got to keep pushing. Circle away from the power side. Go the other way, Fighting Khalid. Don't circle to the right.
Rodtang just coming forward without relief. Gets out of the way. Leans back like Fat Joe. And Rodtang smiles at him. Shakes his head. Says he's got to do better than that fella.
Stop!
On a dump there from Buddy Khalid. That'll give Khalid some confidence.
His double leg takedown. Wrong rule set there from Buddy Khalid.
Rodtang edges forward. Front kick to the guts. Front kick there from Khalid. Evades the left hook. And Rodtang straight back on top of him. Hunting after him. High kick from Khalid. Rodtang hooks the arm, spins him around. Nice little pirouette there from the two-time world champ.
Buddy Khalid's finding a little bit more success, at least in that first minute. He's got to keep the volume high. He has to keep
Rodtang thinking and not allow that aggression to set in.
Rodtang cracks away to the humerus bone, but there was nothing funny about it. Right hand there from Funny Cully. Goes the liver, goes the head. Both punches miss. Spinning back elbow. And Rodtang blocks it. Says, come on! What have you got? Show me your guts and intestinal fortitude! Rodtang fires with a right hand dragon. And they both pull the count.
Yeah, again, long move set. Takedowns are not allowed in this one. You got to keep this on the feet. But Funny Cully's got to keep moving. He can't settle in or he can't get sucked into this game that Rodtang's trying to play.
Rodtang's telling him, don't back up. He wants to fight him toe to toe. He wants to fight him in a phone booth. A jumping roundhouse kick from Rodtang. And he throws him to the canvas. He dumps him to the canvas. Rodtang is an animal. He is an absolute beast. Caution there from referee Onari Mitch.
Onari did not like the takedowns that were being attempted by Fadi Khalid. He's got to move. He can't stand there. This is a better round for him. He has to keep active. He has to keep pushing forward. He can't allow Rodtang to tee off on him like this.
Fadi Khalid had a good idea then. Oh, catch the kicking leg, throw a downward elbow. Just didn't have the time and the distance. There's the downward elbow attempt again. Looking for the collarbone. And Rodtang upends it. Very smart for the 21-year-old. Fadi Khalid ties him up. Rodtang throws a knee. There's another one to the upper left rib cage. The tenderized target of Fadi Khalid. Rodtang shuts him off.
Those knees were nice. He was able to lift up the inside the clinch. He elevates the right side. He elevates that right side and throws a big knee there to the body of Rodtang. That was a good idea.
This is one super series. A Muay Thai clash in four rounds gloves inside a cage between a two-time world champion Rodtang, a six-time national champion in Fadi Khalid.
This is a much better round for Fadi Khalid. Like to see more of that same round from Fadi Khalid. What he did in the second, he needs to do more of it here in the third. Start moving, do not stand in front of Rodtang.
Rodtang with the inside leg kick. Almost buckled the knee of Fadi Khalid. Khalid with the right hand, can't cross. So to the hook of Rodtang. On the front foot again, the 21-year-old two-time world champion.
See, this time, look, he's circling to his right, away from the power side of Rodtang. So Rodtang's having to overextend on the right side. He's not able to put the same power into his shots.
Nice lead elbow there from Fadi Khalid.
He's got to keep in mind the rule set. You can't clinch, you can clinch, but you can't take down off the clinch. And that's what Fadi Khalid was doing. It's buying him a little bit of time, and it's slowing down the tank, but you know, you can't do that. He's issued a yellow card. It's going to cost him 10% of his purse. It doesn't cost him a point, though, just money.
Front kick there from Rodtang. Jab from Fadi Khalid. It's preservation in the clinch for Khalid, I'm sure of it. Front kick to a nice jab and a southpaw stance. Khalid maybe come lifting in the eye. Rodtang says, come on, let's do this. There's the handiwork from Rodtang. Here's the heavy artillery. The clinch now. The beautiful clinch from Rodtang. The vice like grip of the tie. Beautiful knee almost folds him in half.
Rodtang's competing like he's got a couple more rounds in here. I don't know if he realizes that he's only got 90 seconds left in this match. He's got to turn up the volume right now and put an end to this.
The crowd turning up the volume for Rodtang Jitrungdon, a crowd favorite wherever he competes around the world. Spinning back elbow there from Fadi Khalid. Big kick from Rodtang. Khalid trying to find a way to break it overhand right. Nice kick to the liver from Rodtang. Close down that vagus nerve, impact the entire body, put it on delay. Leads under the hook with Khalid, sticks him with the left there, the right hand from Khalid. Good two-punch combination. Dump there on the tank, Rodtang. Under a minute remaining, Dragon.
Rodtang is letting Khalid off the hook. He kind of throws a bunch of combinations. He throws those 3-4 punch combinations, and then he goes in for the clinch rather than finish him on the feet. He's got good evasion, and he's moving. Fadi Khalid put himself.
Looking into the crowd to see that left hook that missed. He was throwing that high back. Rodtang, full commitment behind it. Oh, there's a sticky right hand between the eyes of Rodtang. Downstairs comes Rodtang with a leg kick. taking a backward step for three rounds. Downward elbow. Dumps in again.
Go!
Final seconds. Has one man got a big salvo next year? Carlin tries for it. Two-time world champion Rodtang comes forward once more.
Stop.
No sweep there by Buddy Carlin. And we go to the judges here in Manila. What sportsmanship, what respect there from Rodtang and Buddy Carlin.
All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner. Rodtang Jinwanon.
And they're all behind Rodtang tonight.
They definitely appreciate his Bushido spirit. Immediately attacking that leg, inside and out.
Four rounds gloves, a Muay Thai contest. Rodtang the Tank Jinwanon in the red and silver. Hakim Hamesh of France in the white and black. Goes to the inside thigh, just Rodtang. Good right hand there from Hakim Hamesh. Hamesh, a world Muay Thai champion, multiple times, should not be underestimated, has speed, has precision. We'll need to rely on those two things and the volume against Rodtang.
I'm surprised how Hakim Hamesh is not moving. He's standing right in front of Rodtang and letting Rodtang just hammer on that lead leg.
Let's see how long it takes for Rodtang to get on the inside and start to land the leather. At the moment, kicking range from the tie. Hakim Hamesh drifts off to his right. There's the right hand, smack into the kisser. One to the liver, goes off the left from Rodtang. Uppercut elbow from Rodtang. Already the heavy artillery being launched in the opening round. Kicks to the midsection from the tank, Rodtang. Ooh, Hakim Hamesh stuck with that left hand, and a turning left hook there from the Frenchman. Two of the best Muay Thai countries of the world, well, the best Muay Thai country in the world, Thailand. And you talk about the Western world, well, in history, France is right up there with the Dutch. Maybe a little behind, but not far. We maybe talk about the best Western Muay Thai stylist of all time. There's a big argument to be made for a Frenchman named Danny Bill. Jab two there from Hakim Hamesh.
Interesting strategy right now for coming from Rodtang. You can see that first minute was all about the leg kicks. He was just hammering that big leg of Hamesh inside and out. Now he's choosing to go to the body. You can see the welds starting to add up on that right side of Hakim Hamesh's body. He's attacking with push kicks as well. I think he's trying to soften Hakim Hamesh up, trying to get him to drop that arm and then start to go headhunting.
And two counter there from Hakim Hamesh. A lot of great French kickboxers and Muay Thai athletes over the years. The likes, as I said, of Danny Bill, maybe the greatest. Jerome Labana, Dita Diafant, who was an 11-time world champion. Looping left hand there from Hakim Hamesh. Looking to follow in the footsteps of the Muay Thai greats. We're talking Samar Payakaru, Yotsin Black, Fairtex, Sunshine, Etchemin Chuefe Group, Diesel Noy. Such a long list from the land of smiles. Referee Elias Delapis right on top of the action here. Final seconds of the opening round. It's been entertaining, but really still a filling out process between these two champs. In those 4 ounce gloves, there is no room for error. Accidental groin strike there on Hamesh. Roundhouse kick. And again from Rodtang. Good jab from Hamesh. The jab to it, full extension from the Frenchman. Left hook to a right hook from Rodtang. The tank. Step through knee. Hamesh. Nice tuck there from Hakim Hamesh.
Hakim Hamesh is not giving an inch to Rodtang. He is standing right in front of Rodtang and trading shots with him. We've seen Hakim Hamesh, a beautiful counter striker when he wants to. The beautiful sidestep that he performed on Ogasawara to knock him out in one of the final rounds was absolutely brilliant. But this time, he is going toe-to-toe with one of the best strikers in ONE Championship.
Some really good refereeing here from Elias Delapsis, allowing the clinch to go on. Both men staying busy. Uppercut, trying to snake in that right arm there, Rodtang. Worked the clinch around the back of the neck. Can't get it on at the moment, though. Needed thin section, folds him in half. Elbow tried to come over the top. There's a step uppercut elbow from Rodtang off the lead arm. Crossing elbows from both men. Another crossing elbow from Hakim Hamesh. Uppercut from Rodtang. Good crossing elbow to the jaw from Rodtang. Just losing his footing there, Hakim Hamesh. Rodtang has gone to the next level here in the second round. Good cover up. Close body of Hamesh. Hamesh returns the favor. 1:05 remains. Second round of three. Thailand versus France. Two traditional Muay Thai rivals. Two phenomenal Muay Thai countries.
Man, Rodtang is known as just a destroyer. He just comes forward and he runs through everybody. But he's also very technical. Watch him inside the clinch. The way that he parries arms, the way that he blocks biceps. He is controlling so many different aspects, especially at this close range. It's extremely impressive. Watch that clinch game. See how he controls the biceps like that to prevent Hamesh from grabbing his head.
Beautiful liver shot there from Rodtang. Hakim trying to get inside the guard. Hakim through the forearms of Rodtang. One nod and dumps him to the canvas. Nicely done from Rodtang.
Beautifully done. The way that he came, Hamesh was coming forward, Rodtang sidesteps, swept out the support leg and put Hamesh face down.
Look how Rodtang wears these punches in the forearms, waits for a pause from Hakim Hamesh and then pounds to the body.
Right.
Excellence in execution from Rodtang. Comes forward again to the tie, escapes the uppercut attempt, fires out a front kick, one more round to go. And respect from both of these warriors.
Stop!
Really dump there from Rodtang.
Again, beautifully sidestepped. Fell Hakim Hamesh pushing forward, sweeps the head out.
Another dump from Rodtang. Now, while those might not necessarily score for Rodtang, what it does is it mentally deflates Hamesh. It means he's got to pick himself up off the canvas. Here comes Hamesh with a powerful right hand now. Step through a knee for the Frenchman and a crossing elbow. And Rodtang responds, dumps him again. Continually Hamesh having to pick himself up from these dumps of Rodtang Chipwangon.
It's deflating, it buries your ego. Look at that control, it just shows the dominance that the Iron Man has inside there. The way that he's able to sidestep, sweep, and then he uses his hand to parry the head down of Hamesh to add even more force to the fall.
Clinch, chance for knees. Late knee thrown there from Rodtang. Comes forward again, that high double forearms guard, throws the uppercut on the hook, uppercut from Hamesh, crossing elbow, trying to open the cut on top of the head, glancing right hand from Hamesh. Got to be careful not to drop that head too low, he'll open himself up for a rising knee with Rodtang, and referee Elias Dolapsis breaks him. 1:35 remains, third and final round, Muay Thai contest here in Tokyo, and another dump from Rodtang. I've lost count, Mitch.
Michael, you can see that Rodtang has adapted his guard very well to the small gloves. It's very hard for Hamesh to land the hooks to the head. You can see him landing them. And the way that Rodtang is wearing those on his forearm is extremely professive. I'd like to see Hamesh throw uppercuts. I'd like to see him how he's working the body. That works well, too. Uppercuts to the body shots are going to be how he's going to get this round.
Jab two from Hamesh, a little slow though now from the Frenchman. Glancing left from Rodtang, step up elbow from the Thai. Crossing elbow, wins all out on that one. Rodtang certainly has some powerful salvos left here with 45 seconds on the clock. Hakim Hamesh glances towards his corner. They are imploring him, but it's in French. I don't know what they're saying, but I think get the general gist. It's come forward. You've got to throw hell for leather now. Uppercut from Hamesh. Listens to his corner.
That's how he's going to find those holes in Rodtang's guard. He's got to land those uppercuts. Go to the body.
Nice elbow there from Rodtang to the orbital of Hakim Hamesh. There's the uppercut from the Frenchman.
Rodtang is using those elbows beautifully. Every time he gets into range, every time he's able to control the positioning of the arms, he's able to sneak those elbows right over the top and connect.
Final seconds of a brilliant contest. And we go down to the judges. Look at the respect. Look at the honor. Look at the martial arts values displayed from these two world champions.
Man, it all came down to those close-range weapons of Rodtang. Look at that. He's able to slip the big left hook coming from Hamesh, but then he's able to answer right back. Lance shot, look at that. He just wears it on the chin, marches forward, shrugs the head up, but then watch the work of Rodtang inside that clinch. Look how he parries the arm down, gets him thinking about the other side, and then lands another big forearm. These are just barely missing and landing with the forearm and not the elbow because Hakeem Hamesh is so good at manipulating distance.
After three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this bout in favor of the red corner. Judge number two scores this bout in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three scores this contest in favor of your winner by split decision from the red corner.
Unleashes with kicks to the inside of the leg, to the outside, and then a teep kick. Takes one in return. It's a battle of the feet at the moment. Exchanging, slapping kicks that will leave bruises for sure. And it's Sok T who's on the rough end of it. He goes upstairs, Rodtang. Gets pushed back.
Man, I need some slow motion replays on those kicks of Rodtang. Those are coming with some serious speed.
Real hit. 30 seconds. Hands come into play as well at the 42nd mark. Sok T just hoists up his shorts, seeking any protection he can get from these body blows that are coming in at pace. It's lightning quick, Mitch.
It is, and it's coming with some serious power as well. You hear it's a slap, but there's also a thud to the inside of that leg kick as well. Sok T can't allow Rodtang to back his back up against the fence right there. You can see him just slowly inching forward, throwing those leg kicks to just kind of pin Sok T there. Alexei Sok T circle out.
It's not an exaggeration to say that these kicks are coming in so quickly. Sometimes you're not sure what you've seen. Nice left hand work. Goes body and head, Rodtang. Superb offensive work here, and he bashes himself in the chest and in the face. He's taken more punishment from himself than he has from his opponent in the last 10 seconds. Really up for this. And those legs of Sok T are taking some punishment. He just pushes his opponent back 4 or 5 feet, giving himself a little bit of respite. Doubles up on a jab that lands short. But at the moment, he's off the pace.
Sok T's kind of mesmerized at this point. He's got to do something in the respect of Rodtang.
These two hyper-experienced 21-year-olds.
Fainted the jab and then came around to the beautiful left hook.
Sok T just showing us the potential threat there with a big overhand right that might possibly have brushed the nose of Rodtang. But at the moment, all of the really quite exquisite work is coming from the tie. And it's relentless. There's no room to breathe. They keep coming in every couple of seconds. Jab, kick. T gives him a nod after receiving a left hook to the jaw. A nod of respect. Left, right, followed up by kicks. This is exhibition stuff from the Thai athlete.
Leg kicks.
Left hand, and down goes Sok T, and I'm not convinced that he's getting up.
5, 6, 7.
He clearly hurt his leg. He's nodding, yes, I can continue, but it doesn't look feasible, Mitch, does it? Saved by the bell.
He's got to check some of these kicks.
Oh, left hand, right kick, deep kick. Sok T comes back with something, and that's what he has to do. He's got to send a message to his opponent. Meanwhile, right left, that leg is in big trouble, isn't it?
He's just walking him down, putting his back up against the fence, and then just throwing some nasty combinations. They're all ending with leg kicks.
You've got to admire Sok T's resilience here. And the resistance, but for how much longer? superb left hook to the body, like Barry McGuigan of old in the 80s. Once again, left hand and right hand. Kicks to the body as well. Again, he goes downstairs with that wonderful left hook to the body.
Just ultra-aggressive. Rodtang marching forward. The tank is rolling through Bangkok.
That is a gorgeous left hook to the body. That leg, how much more can it stand? Again, he goes left hook to the body, right to the head, kicks to the left leg. Sok T stays on his feet, directly above us here, circle side, in Bangkok at the Impact Arena. And Rodtang is thrilling these fans.
How tough is Sok T? He's still in it. He's not backing down, he's not going anywhere.
Left hook to the body, the tree has come down. He attacked that trunk, runs across the circle, sits atop, taps his chest and says, hey, who's number one? It could well be me. What a performance, as close to exhibition Muay Thai as we've seen for quite a while. Of course the respect that we're used to seeing. Sok T, for the time being, unable to get to his feet. But that did not stop Rodtang from going over there and offering his condolences. That left leg of Sok T was taking huge punishment. You can see him hobbling around, doing all he can, but that was the finishing blow. Inside and outside of Sok T's left leg, and then a barrage of punches. Left, right, left, right, left, right. Sok T's left leg is going to be sore tomorrow. It's pretty sore now.
Your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 36 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Rodtang
This one brought to you by Hobbs and Shaw. Champion from the UK, left of screen, their challenger from Thailand, right of screen. They exchange round kicks early. Look for the elbows, look for the front kicks. There's one from Haggerty. Look for the sheer brute power of Rodtang in some leg kick from the top. More than 140 martial arts world champions on the roster at one championship. You are seeing two of them in the ring at the moment.
Go!
You've got to wonder, can Rodtang maintain his composure? High check there. Jab two from Haggerty. That's the precision, that's the excellence of execution from the general.
Good work so far from Haggerty, especially with these kicks, man. And that's what he's doing. He's laying that bait. Now he landed a few push kicks, and now he's starting to fake the push kicks. And that's how he sets up those elbows. He slides in forward and throws those elbows off of that fake push kick.
The push kick of Haggerty, one of the best in the business. Pulls the toes back, extends the ball, the foot, drives it into the midsection of the opponent. Roundhouse kick from Haggerty. And there's the push kick, and it's set Rodtang back against the ropes. Again, the second on technique of the 22-year-old world champion from the UK. Front kick again from Haggerty. Scoring points. We do have three judges ringside. Scoring on a 10-point must system. Give the winning boxer 10 points per round. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. At the moment, with the front kicks, it's Haggerty doing the scoring.
Rodtang's having a hard time with the range of Haggerty. That lead push kick is causing a lot of problems for Rodtang. Rodtang's not usually just standing there taking these shots. He's usually the one pushing forward, throwing those shots.
He is landing every one of these front kicks. There's a downward elbow, hoping to crack the collarbone. When we spoke to Haggerty yesterday, we said, what were you most looking forward to about competing against Rodtang? He said, I can't wait to kick him. I can't wait to front kick him. And he's done plenty of that so far, with 45 seconds remaining in the first round set for five.
All those, I like that little change, that little stance change that he does as he throws that
Right kick.
Look at his flyweight Muay Thai world title on the line. There's a front kick off the lead leg from the general. Nice 3-2 combination. Inside leg from Rodtang, the Iron Man. Both wearing the Project armbands, a little more flamboyant. Those around the left bicep of Haggerty. The more super Project around both the biceps of Rodtang. All part of the tradition, the custom, the superstition of Muay Thai, a martial art dating back some 3,000 years. Front kick again. Catches up at this Rodtang. End of the round, we go to the towers. Now once again, the winning boxer of the round, 10 points. Front kicks again from Haggerty. Checks the inside leg kick. Rodtang, you feel, is just trying to get his timing off that front kick to work a counter. Maybe it'll be a big overhand right. Maybe it'll be a hooking punch. But that's what he's going to try and time off, the front kick of Haggerty. There you see it again. A catch and counter, scooping to the liver section.
Now he catches it. Now you're starting to see Rodtang. You can see him at the end of that first round kind of pounding his chest, firing himself up, shaking his head. That's the Rodtang we're used to seeing.
There is a moment in previous contests we've seen where Rodtang goes from Bruce Banner to the Incredible Hulk. Are we going to see it here in the second round? We will see it later on. Nice, hook to the outside leg kick there from Rodtang. Haggerty switches stance, southpaw now. Front kick off the back leg, now back to orthodox. Very tight in his guard here, Jonathan Haggerty, a 22-year-old world champion from England. Sticks the front kick into the guts again of Rodtang. Good outside leg kick, high on the thigh there from Haggerty.
Rodtang's starting to evade a lot of these kicks now. He's moving his head a lot better, getting out of the way of these. I think he's trying to figure out the reach there. You can see just how long the leg reach, the advantage that Haggerty has. Rodtang's starting to figure it out a little bit more. Expect Haggerty to start going to the legs and body a little bit more.
Rodtang has the edge in power, but Haggerty, it looks like, has the edge in speed and precision. Downward elbow, looks for a dump, says Haggerty. The blow there off the referee Onari went to break them, and Haggerty complaining to Onari there.
Yeah, but it wasn't quite really a break. Like, the referee was there, but he didn't really have his hands in there separating them. So, I don't know, maybe it was the angle that I didn't quite see, but it looked like Onari wasn't really trying to break him.
Front kick there from Haggerty. Once again, folks, make sure you follow One Championship across all social media platforms on Instagram, on Facebook, and on Twitter. A lot of fans watching tonight. Big hello to Mauro Pomali watching in Tuscany, Italy tonight. High kick from Haggerty. Tried to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Outside thigh kick from Rodtang. Now we're seeing Rodtang raise the mercury, raise the temperature, raise the aggressor meter.
This is what Rodtang has to do. He cannot allow Haggerty to push forward and be this aggressive. He's got to slow Haggerty's aggression down. Cut him off, start putting heat on him.
Two down, three remaining. Strap yourselves in for the ride of a lifetime.
Michael, that's what happened to Sam A. Gyeonghadao. We saw Jonathan Haggerty get ahead in the first couple rounds, and Sam A. Gyeonghadao never got a chance to get back into it because Haggerty just kept pouring it on.
We'll see Rodtang now. He'll start the showboating. He'll start the theater. And he'll start the heavy sailboat. Hooking punches from Rodtang. Haggerty tries to dump him. Rodtang looks to return the favor. Both men trade knees to the ribs. And referee Onari breaks it.
That's what Rodtang needs to do. He needs to keep Haggerty on his back foot. Not allow Haggerty to go forward and control all those feints.
Rodtang coming forward a lot more already here in this third round of five. That's what he does. That's why they call him the tank. He just comes forward and rolls over you. Project Armband slipping down. Looks to be leaving there. There's Rodtang. Haggerty tries to counter with a hook off the ropes. Drifts back clockwise. Thrusts out the jab. You see Rodtang trying to walk him down. He wasn't doing that the first two rounds. Is Haggerty going to stand and go toe-to-toe? Has he going to play that game? Is he going to try and let Rodtang's ego open him up here? Rodtang goes to the liver. Have you felt that one?
crossed out the track. Circles off to his left, but he's going into the power side. Another liver shot, like he's digging for oil. This is a great round for Rodtang. Haggerty evades the leg kick, takes the inside thigh kick, goes high, misses the target. Checks the low kick, jab from Haggerty. Gotta get off the ropes though. Gotta get off the ropes though. Gotta get off the ropes. And now he does, after running an elbow.
It's a much better round for Rodtang. This is what we expect from the Iron Man. To go forward and throw
a downward elbow! And a dump there from Rodtang. Another downward elbow! It's a big intent from Jonathan Haggerty. But we told you Rodtang would wait to the third round and pick up the pace. Indeed, he's done that in true Thai fashion.
But Haggerty's landing shots too. He's landing a lot of clear shots. We've seen the aggression from Rodtang, and the crowd might be ooh and on, but Haggerty is picking him away, slowly landing jabs, landing kicks.
Jab two combination from the champion on the high kick. Rodtang goes downstairs. Outside leg kick from Rodtang. Left hook. Haggerty fires the elbow. Goes down the center corridor. A beautiful catching dump there from Rodtang. It's scoring stuff from Rodtang.
Do you like the counters of Haggerty so far? I like how he's throwing a combination. He steps, then he throws that right kick or that left kick, and he steps back. And that's when Rodtang starts to come forward, and Haggerty's able to hit him or something.
Front kick again from Haggerty, finding range. Outside leg kick from Rodtang.
All that pressure.
The hooking punches and the power up of the four-ounce blocks. You see Haggerty trying to slice and dice and fillet there with the uppercut elbow. Good front kick, nice long extension off the lead leg. Jab from Haggerty.
A little bit of deflection right there from Rodtang as that jab came in lightning fast.
Nice tip to the lead thigh from Haggerty. Then skips up inside thigh kick, threads the jab again, takes an outside lead kick. Body shots. Oh, the shots hurt him. The liver shots hurt the champion.
Haggerty's got to move.
And Rodtang knows it. He's going to go to that liver. He's going to try and blast the right side of the body of the champion. And Haggerty needs to find a way to cut him. Needs to find a way to open him up with the elbows now. And he drops it. The big kibosh. And Haggerty goes down. Referee O'Malley puts the count on. Haggerty's up on his feet. But he's been rattled. It was a beautiful hooking punch from Rodtang. And here comes the Iron Man. Here comes the tag. Ticking time bomb has exploded. Rodtang marching him down. Eats a jab. Haggerty circles away from the power side. There's a front kick. Haggerty's got to give himself a chance to recover. And Rodtang says, step dancing. Come and engage with me. He's trying to get inside Haggerty's mind. He wants Haggerty to play his game. Wants him to suck it into a brawl. But Haggerty not falling for it. He's not going to take the bait yet. Oh, nice front kick there. A taste of the feet once again for Rodtang. Downward elbow. Hoping for the collarbone. Jack. But he's doing a Beyonce. He's going to the left, to the left. He's going to go to the right, to the right. Go. Stay away from the power side of Rodtang.
He's doing a good job of slowing down. Go. He says, this is for a belt. Come on, let's go toe to toe.
And how about this?
Get into it.
Haggerty calling Rodtang forward, saying, no. You come on, you bring it. I'm not coming to you, you're gonna come to me.
Yeah, that's just mind games though. He's still moving though, he's on his bicycle. Looks at him, points to the ground, says let's go.
Haggerty playing the mind games. Saying I made you lose your ground. Come on back into the phone booth.
Oh, it's gonna come down to the fifth and final. With that knockdown, Rodtang could have a slight edge in the scoring.
Once again, winning boxer gets 10 points. Losing boxer in the round, in your opinion, gets 9. Usually, if there's a knockdown, it's a 10-8 round.
Yeah, I think that knockdown changed it, though. I think it changed it. Beautiful evasion there from Rodtang.
Rodtang showboats. A little too slick. Roundhouse kick from the top. Haggerty cheek down the center. Needs the elbows. 2 now. And not allow Rodtang to go to his liver and then sling the hand to the jaw. Those hooking punches of Rodtang are phenomenal. And the general goes to the legs. One way to slow down the punching of opponent
is to kick their legs. Every good punch begins from the bottom of the feet and comes up the body.
Haggerty's scoring with the leg kicks there, but you can see Rodtang catching the kick, sweeping out the leg, putting it down. Now dumps do count as a clean technique.
Tries to push kick. Haggerty. Rodtang may be waiting for the final 60 seconds or so here.
He can't wait though. Haggerty's doing a lot of scoring here with these legs, pushing on the teeth.
Yeah, this
look at
is
that.
Haggerty's round so far, no
that's
doubt
scoring,
about it.
That's scoring, Michael. That's scoring. All these things are scoring.
Rodtang throws two punches, doesn't connect, tucks the round kick on the forearm. Haggerty catches that one. There's one to the humerus, but there was nothing funny about it. Haggerty, nice roundhouse kick. Rodtang on the front foot, eats a jab. Body shots, then the hook for the head. Chance for the knees and elbows on the inside here.
Strong into that clinch, wraps his hand around the head. There's a little bit of a knee, but chooses to let it go.
1 minute, 5 remaining. Fifth and final round for the Flyweight Championship of the World. Jab 2 from Jonathan Haggerty. Front kick from Haggerty. It has been superb all night. It is the prime weapon of the champion. Nice stiff right hand. Rodtang apologizing. We'll say no, maybe Haggerty accidentally slipped a finger in the eye. It happens with these open gloves. Front kick, testing the waters here, Haggerty. And he thread an overhand elbow to the top of the head, perhaps. Or maybe skip in for a downward elbow to the collarbone.
30 seconds, Michael. This is it, right here. Last 30.
There's one of these two men pounce on the other now. Jab two, a high kick from Jonathan Haggerty.
Nice two landing there by Haggerty as he cut through the guard.
This is going to be razor close, folks. This is going to be a razor close decision. Haggerty switches now back to orthodox.
Haggerty can take this round. It might be even, and they have to go to criteria for that.
No draws in one super series. No draws. We are going down to the judges. This is razor close. This is harder to pick than a broken nose. I don't know what to say about this one, Mitch.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And new one Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion, Rodtang
Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you, red trunks of the champion, Rodtang Chiwangdong. As Mitch said, the Iron Man could start slowly, do a bit of window shopping, see what Gonsalves has to offer, and then open up. Good inside leg kick there from Rodtang. Gonsalves could not allow Rodtang to establish rhythm. Outside leg kick from Gonsalves.
Gonsalves spent a long time training and competing in Thailand, so he says he's used to the style which Rodtang brings, but I gotta say, Michael, I don't know how many people are competing exactly like Rodtang do. That head kick could have woke up a sleeping beast inside Rodtang.
Overhead right smack bang! Rodtang has tasted the power of Gonsalves early in these 4 rounds clock.
This first round is Gonsalves' opportunity. This is where he needs to jump on Rodtang while he's going nice and slow.
Gonsalves, WPMF World Champion, spins back to set to circle, high on the ball to his feet. Rodtang, who defeated Jonathan Haggerty of the UK for the Flyweight World title. Jab overhand right here from Gonsalves and received a poke to the eye.
Injury time.
My word, what a start though from Walter Gonsalves. Shot him so respectfully to that man, Rodtang Chiwangdong.
You can see Rodtang just framed out his hand. It's a defensive strategy to stop an oncoming opponent. And with these open-fingered gloves, it creates some exciting matches, but it just
just graze the eye completely inadvertent. Not something Rodtang meant to do. An athlete is allowed up to 3 minutes, that's the duration of a round, for medical examination and recovery. If an athlete is unable to continue in the allotted time, an official decision will be given. Now, we only go to a judge's scorecards if there is a, if we reach past the halfway point, or in this case, we reach that fourth round, but Gonzalez doesn't need that much time. He is ready to get back to action.
Rodtang Jitwangdon, the son of rubber tree farmers, and his first Muay Thai match as an eight-year-old at a temple fair. After just 2 weeks training, he won the match. Down in 2 points from Sawat, southern Thailand. Salvez must have confidence. The left hook there from Rodtang, and he calls Gonzalez for it. Taste of the power from Rodtang Jitwangdon. The Iron Man still hasn't gotten out of first gear though. He does be afraid. They clinch up. Huge cut. Tries to put it through the canvas. Walter Gonsalves introducing himself to over 140 countries tonight.
Potentially 2.5 billion people are watching this young man compete. Good movement, and we see Gonsalves. He's managing the distance, moving back. He's going to consistently switch stances.
Gonsalves. Lots of confidence on the Brazilian. Bouncing up and down, switching stance. Leg check there from Rodtang. Overhand right just on the bell, and he got the towel. Southpaw stance here on Gonsalves. Second of five. Outside leg kick on Salvez. Looping the tag from the Brazilian. Very long arms on him. Could be a huge shot. Salvez knocks out Rodtang. As I said, 86% of fans on him. One app fantasy game have tipped a Rodtang win tonight. Not to mention most pundits believe Rodtang will get the win. Salvez, who is impressing so far, who is pulling the trigger on his strikes. Outside leg at the end, Gonsalves scores for it. Catch and counter. Rodtang closes that down.
Stop!
And they go to each other, referee Salvez breaks them.
Salvez has a lightning fast shot. His follow up shot to set things up.
Gonsalves begin for the counter off the legs of Rodtang. Clash of legs, clash of shields. Catch and counter again from Gonsalves. Gotta be careful though, Gonsalves. He's not willing to telegraph that catch and counter, or Rodtang will read it, will bait him.
Stop!
All pitched up, the ball there from a referee to Lapsus. Rodtang, gloves are high. Round kick goes to the right ribs. Gonsalves on the back foot. Good sticky left hand there from Walter. Rodtang edging forward, not throwing the hands though. There's the hook. Gonsalves saw it coming. Double forearms guard against the round kick. And again, blocking the round kick. Counters off it. A round kick of his own from Gonsalves. And Rodtang says,
can't get sucked into this. Rodtang, look at him, just angry, pounding on his chest, beckoning him forward, trying to get him to come in and exchange in a firestorm with him. But Gonsalves keeping his composure, he's not getting suckered into this. He's moving back, keeping that distance, and he's landing.
Up the orbital there. And Gonsalves returns the favor. And now Gonsalves has worked with Rodtang. And still Gonsalves on the back foot. Will he go to the phone booth?
Stop! Break!
Will he make that call? Rodtang wants it. Switch high kick there from Rodtang.
Stop!
Oh, sweet. Just after the bell from Walter Gonsalves. Invasion again from Gonsalves.
There's the catch and counter from Gonsalves that he's been using for the previous two rounds. Step across elbow, left hook from the Brazilian, drifts off to center circle. Spinning back elbow, Gonsalves. Rodtang trying to walk him down, but he's not finding a standing target. Short elbows now from Rodtang on the inside.
This is nice trajectory
of the knee.
This is key. He's got to keep that head moving. I like how he's coming in, and you can see Rodtang overcommits with some of those punches. That's when he's starting to throw that spinning back elbow.
Stop!
Tries to dump in. Just Gonsalves had a huge dump in the opening round on Rodtang. He's done full play into the judges. No doubt about that.
Hey, come on!
Referee Talapsis wants to see a little more engagement from these two. Rodtang smiling at Gonsalves. Gonsalves goes downstairs from Blair.
Stop! Come on! Come here!
Yeah. Come out here yeah. From referee Talapsis if they're not careful.
Hey. Action!
Rodtang no, saying he yeah. Wants okay. Gonsalves to engage, but the onus is also on the champion.
Gonsalves has got to keep moving forward. He can't keep moving back. He can't engage with Rodtang. That is not a smart strategy. He's got to keep scoring, keep throwing the leg kicks, and consistently move. Not staying in front.
Gonsalves got hit with a left hand and said, come on, is that all you've got? Oh, he goes down there. And Rodtang says, referee Talapsis from the hook of Rodtang. And Rodtang comes forward again. Roundhouse kick to the ribs. Hat-trick counter there from Gonsalves. Low kick to the back leg. Out of southpaw stance. Body shot, hook, misses for Rodtang. 45 seconds, 4-5 drag.
Gonsalves doing a good job of shutting down the offense of Rodtang, not getting baited into the games. Rodtang's gonna have to cut that circle off.
Roundhouse kick from Rodtang. Gonsalves on the outside. Three judges circle side, scoring on a 10-point must system. The middle round gets 10 points. Gets 9 points. 10-8 if there's a knockdown usually. No knockdown so far. Back over. So too for Rodtang. This crowd oohs and ahs every time Rodtang comes. Agonizingly close.
And that's what he's doing. He's coming close, but he's not landing full. You can see.
An ultimate round here. Rodtang has the experience. 310 bouts to Gonsalves' 70.
Man, razor close three rounds. It'll be very interesting to see how the judges have this scored so far. He's got that constant aggression coming from Rodtang. We're seeing a lot of counter strikes and clean techniques from Gonsalves.
Rodtang's last knockout in one second. With leg kicks over Subtee, and one Warriors of Light back on May 10. 1:36 of the second round that one came in.
It's the second off-balancing punch that Rodtang's thrown, and it's, you know, Gonsalves down, but it's kind of just off-balancing him, and he's tripping him. Disrupting his balance, Gonsalves pops back up, so no knockdown yet, scored by Talapsis. A tie kick.
Rodtang made his one Super Series debut back in September 2018 against Sergio Vilsen of the Netherlands. Vilsen, a decorated world champion, line fight world champion. Rodtang took care of business without too many hits. And again, referee is going to really give a stern warning now.
Listen, one more time, yellow card, okay? Action.
Let's jump on to get on. Elias Talapsis' bad side. He wants to see more engagement. Uppercut elbow from Gonsalves. Mitch, referee Talapsis was a big tap again from Gonsalves. Oh, Rodtang claimed it was a throwback. Looked like a good enough dump to me. So too to referee Talapsis. Referee Talapsis did say, Mitch, a caution could be coming for a yellow card. What would that entail?
That would include a 10% deduction from the purse of each athlete, whoever receives the yellow card.
As forward as Rodtang. I believe, Mitch, I really do, that Rodtang has been frustrated by Gonsalves here. I don't think he knew what he was stepping into, that Gonsalves would bring it to Rodtang as much as the Brazilian has.
And neither did 80% of the fans, too.
86% of fans believing Rodtang will win. Oh, elbow there from Gonsalves. Look at that equation. He makes Rodtang all over by his own momentum.
See, I don't think referee Galopsis is warning them about, you know, the backward movement of Gonsalves. I think he's warning them about the time that Rodtang is complaining, that pause in the action.
Rodtang's frustrated. No doubt about it in my mind. They spin around against the circle fence again, throw short knees on the inside.
With very good reasons. Stop. You see the way he puts everything he has into these shots.
Gonsalves
slides out of the way.
Exactly. You see the way that Gonsalves evades these big strikes. And just a moment ago, we saw the momentum of Rodtang, the southpaw Walter Gonsalves of Brazil, giving Rodtang a contest unlike anything we've seen before here in one Super Series. Clinching knees early.
You can see he's looking for that again. Nice little trip there. Good balance shown by Gonsalves.
Stop.
Now, what Rodtang was complaining about is you're not allowed to pick somebody up and then throw them. That's what he was questioning the referee about.
Rodtang edging forward. Fake there from Gonsalves. Two punch combination. Gets out of the range of the counter. Right hand. Knees from Rodtang. That one to the lower spine.
Break.
Not permitted. Referee Galopsis breaks them. Rodtang comes forward again. He wants a brawl with Gonsalves. Gonsalves refuses to be suckered in.
Stop.
AKA Brazilian kick.
Up.
Which is
the end of
my Brazilian.
Both.
Great Brazilian kickboxers and Muay Thai athletes over the years, the likes of Flyweight Feitosa, of course, one's own Cosmo Alessandre, Francisco Filio. Rodtang backing up Gonsalves, scooping bolo punch into the midsection. High kick there from Rodtang. It's time for Gonsalves to start landing some scoring shots now.
Backing up still, he's got good head movement, he's able to all the power shots, but he's not getting suckered in by the psychological games of Rodtang.
Overhand elbow from Gonsalves, double forearms guard against the round kick. Rodtang continually on the front foot.
Stop!
Well,
it's right.
Rodtang was complaining about the throw off a dump earlier, but how about that for Rodtang? Tying him up with almost a choke there. Left hook from Rodtang. Roundhouse kick. Good counter right hand from Gonsalves. Southpaw stance has gone to orthodox now, Gonsalves, and it's working for him.
And that right hand slips right through the guard. It's scoring heavily from Gonsalves.
Spinning back elbow, and Rodtang got underneath it. Switching stance, Gonsalves just trying to confound Rodtang a little more. 30 seconds remaining. Final round. He's going to engage.
He's trying to push forward, but Gonsalves just slides out of the way, ends up on the other side of the circle, evading all counter shots.
A very frustrating contest for Rodtang, Chip 1-9. Walter Gonsalves' introduction to one Super Series will win him a lot of fans. And there it is. We're going down the judges here in Tokyo. And they're both, they're both posing in center circle, mirroring each other.
And that's a pretty close matchup there, Michael Cervello.
Who's going to get the fence first? Let's see. Incredible showmen, incredible athletes. It's Rodtang who gets off first.
Michael Cervello, let's take a look at that kick that Gonsalves landed. Beautifully timed. Look at that. Sets it up with the push kick, switches stances. And then boom, just goes up and then comes right back down. He landed it with the push kick. Look at him. Throws the push kick. He looks like he's gonna throw it again when he switches the stance. Look at this, brings it up and then wraps that foot right around the face of Rodtang.
After five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one, calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the red corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision. And still one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang.
Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. Rodtang opens up with a leg kick. High kick there from Haggerty. Checks the low kick. Both men trading legs early. Nice jab from Haggerty. There's the front kick is renowned for. Rear leg roundhouse kick. Rodtang took a while to open up last time. Not until the third did he really get going. Will he start more explosively tonight? He said he would. He said he'd go in early against Haggerty. Haggerty told us, I'm playing to Rodtang's ego. Says Rodtang has a massive ego. Rodtang will want to play to the crowd and that will open him up. Rodtang looks for the inside and outside thighs. Haggerty left roundhouse kick. Rodtang goes to the liver. A taste of the power early in these 4 ounce gloves. There is no room for error. Good right hand there from Haggerty. There's the front kick to the face and Haggerty's hurt. The body shot. The body shot's hurt him in the first round. It's the aggressive start from Rodtang. The body shot hurts Haggerty. And the tank comes forward. Can Haggerty survive? 1 minute 45 remaining. Rodtang goes straight back to the liver. It's a soft spot. The body of Haggerty. The liver punches to the right side of the carcass. There he goes again. Haggerty against the ropes is in trouble. And Rodtang, cool and collected, throws the elbow to the orbital.
Haggerty's got to move. He cannot stand in front of Rodtang like this. He's got to get on that bicycle and start circling now. If his body is damaged, he's got to move. Utilize that push kick. Keep that distance. Do not stand in punching range with the Iron Man.
Outside leg kick from Rodtang. He's hurt the body of Haggerty. The liver shot dropping the man from the UK. They tie up now. Looks for a dump to Haggerty. Can't affect it. Throws the knee to the waist of Rodtang. And referee Delapsis breaks it. What a start though from Rodtang, the champion. Good jab there from Haggerty. Rodtang goes back to the liver. He may be telegraphing it. Goes upstairs with a hook of the lead hand. Good right hand down the center corridor. Outside thigh kick. Another digging liver shot like he's digging for oil. It's all about the liver. It's all about the body work from Rodtang here in the first round. And Haggerty goes top of the thigh, throws an overhand elbow, puts the jab in the face again, circles off clockwise, checks the low kick. He's moving into Rodtang's power side. High kick again. Feet meet mouth. Final 10 seconds of a 10-8 round here for Rodtang. Throws the left hand. Overhand elbow from Haggerty, trying to lop the ear off, Van Gogh style. Body shot from Rodtang. End of the first round, we go to the towels. Second round set for 5-10-8 opening round for Rodtang. Front kick there from Haggerty. Very light on the lead foot, switches to southpaw here, does the man from the UK. Rodtang edging his way forward, trying to get inside the phone booth to land the liver shot again. Haggerty back to orthodox stance. Rodtang goes to the liver. What do you do though when Rodtang is hunting your liver? Do you drop your arm down? You do that, then he goes after your head. Switching stances here, Haggerty.
Haggerty's got to stay mobile. He has to keep that push kick coming, utilize those kicks. Keep him at distance. Do not let him get close like this.
When Rodtang gets close, Haggerty's got to throw the elbows, got to hope to open up Rodtang. That was part of the game plan. Let Rodtang come to him, slice and dice and fillet with the elbows. Rodtang continually coming forward. So calm, so composed. Chin tucked, looking through his brow.
Goes the liver again. He knows that's the sweet spot. It's like a target painted on the right side of the body of Jonathan Haggerty. No knockdown there, says referee Dilapsis. They touch gloves. Halfway through the second round of five, this world title match. Haggerty with the counter kick. Jab from Jonathan Haggerty, the former world champion. Won the title by defeating the great Sam A. Gangadao in Jakarta. Lost the title to Rodtang in Manila.
Beautiful evasion there of the sweep for Rodtang as he got airborne as Haggerty tried to sweep out that support leg.
Switching stance again, Haggerty from southpaw to orthodox. Orthodox is his preferred stance. Body shot from Rodtang. Haggerty against the ropes, gets off there, drifts back to center ring. Looks for the inside leg. Want to see the overhand elbows come into play here from Haggerty. Maybe a spinning back elbow off the right arm. He goes for a liver shot of his own. There's a front kick to the guts.
Haggerty's got to be careful when Rodtang catches those kicks. You can see how Rodtang's throwing the legs aside, and then he starts digging for those body shots.
Haggerty not coming in with the elbows again on that occasion, though I feel the left side of the head of Rodtang was exposed. Southpaw stance, back leg kick, gets out of the way of the right hand counter. Rodtang comes forward, goes to the liver again. I've lost count of how many body shots to the liver Rodtang has thrown inside of two rounds.
Well, Michael, if Haggerty tries to go in for those elbows, he's going to close that distance and enter Rodtang's punching range. I think he wants to keep that distance and keep that space.
And possibly a 10-9 second round for Rodtang. Good jab there from Haggerty. Rodtang forcing him back against the ropes. Haggerty doesn't want to go there. Dump from Rodtang, nicely executed. Haggerty needs to get to that teep kick. Needs those elbows. Hooking punches from Rodtang. Haggerty calls him forward. That's usually what Rodtang does to opponents. Is he going to try and open up the ego now of Rodtang? We haven't seen Rodtang slap his face or pound his chest or play to the audience yet. It's been a much more tame Rodtang, though it's been a very aggressive Rodtang.
This is where Haggerty's got to be careful. He can't engage in these types of exchanges with Rodtang, where he gets pushing backwards, because that's how he lost his footing, got knocked down in the fourth round last time. He has to keep his footwork going, utilize those shots. There's that downward elbow that you were calling for, Michael.
Going for the collarbone cracker. There's a little shot from Rodtang. Haggerty having words with Elias Dilapsis, the referee. Maybe a thumb or something in the eye of Haggerty. Some injury time being called here as the doctor takes a look at the eye of Jonathan Haggerty. Haggerty, I feel, is trying to enter into the mental space of Rodtang here in the third. He wants Rodtang's ego to open up so Rodtang will maybe expose himself, maybe leave himself open and make a mistake. There it is, a thumb in the eye off the left hand, accidentally, of course, from Rodtang. It's Muay Thai in 4 ounce gloves. It's the main event of one championship, a new tomorrow. The first show of 2020. A massive 50 events across all of one championship's platforms for 2020. Our biggest year is upon us. Jonathan Haggerty needs to find a way to turn the tide here. Got knocked down in the opening round, courtesy of a liver shot. Had Rodtang up in his face in the second round. Rodtang wanting Haggerty to come forward on him. Haggerty refusing. He wants Rodtang to come forward on him. He wants to bait Rodtang. Hope that Rodtang will make a mistake, will slip up, will leave himself exposed. Haggerty on the outside. Rodtang about to up the aggressor meter, it looks like. Good right hand there, jaw rattler from Haggerty. Another one there from the Brit. Rodtang backs him off, body shot, belly button through the back, liver shot, down again. Yeah. It's deafening in here. The second time Haggerty's been dropped with a liver shot and he's also cut. Front kick. He gets put on his backside. Here comes Rodtang, here comes the power. Boom to the body again. Referee calls time. Is it a mouth guard dislodged? It is.
Haggerty's got to be careful at this point. He's getting sucked into that exchange with Rodtang. He's got to move. Get on that bicycle. Do not play with this dangerous, dangerous game with Rodtang.
Rodtang going for the finish. Backs off Haggerty again. They are two 22-year-olds. And now you see Rodtang's ego coming into play. The beating of the chest, the slapping of the face. That's what Haggerty wanted. That's the Rodtang Haggerty said he prepared for. Now let's see if he finds an opening. A jumping knee doesn't get through. Here comes Rodtang. The power, the power, the power, the power, the punishment. Haggerty down for a second time in the round. If he goes down once more in this round, it's over.
He's got 32 seconds to survive.
If he goes down once more, it's over in this round. Here comes Rodtang. Rodtang, 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 Rodtang. Liver, then to the temple, goes the liver again, the onslaught, the barrage. This is the tank at his finest. This is the Iron Man, all over and smothering Haggerty. Third knockdown in the round, all over. Have a look at the onslaught, 4 ounce gloves. One of the hardest hitters in the combat world, going to your body like that. Glancing left, powerful right to the orbital. You see the eyes of Haggerty a little bit glassed there as he backs off, but Rodtang just kept coming forward. There was no relent. Left hook, right hand, Haggerty, double forearms guard, has a look, lifts the arms. As he lifts the arms, Rodtang goes the body, and then he goes straight to the center. The solar plexus, followed by the liver shot, followed by the head shot. Boom to the liver, clean liver shot.
By way of technical knockout, and still one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang.
He's had 262 career wins. Pit Dampit Indy Academy, the challenger, 96 career wins. 5-1 in one super series, 3 knockouts for Pit Dam. 7-0, undefeated here in one for Rodtang. They are 1-1. This is a trilogy match. Rodtang lost to Pit Dam at Rajdamund Stadium in 2017. Beat him in 2018, also at Rajdamund Stadium. Rodtang, who won the flyweight Muay Thai world title against Jonathan Haggerty in Manila in August, made his first title defense against Walter Gonsalves in Tokyo last October, second defense against Haggerty in January in Bangkok. Known for his punching power, his aggression. He is a pure version of what you call a Muay mutt.
I'm late.
That's a power boxer. Power with technique. Rodtang's all about the power. Pit Dam, renowned for that rear leg roundhouse kick. See what he did to Josh Tonner. What he did to Kenny C. He can put the lights out on you with a body kick or a head kick. Pit Dam, of course, the former one flyweight kickboxing world champion. Won the title against Alias Mahmoudi here in Bangkok. Lost the title on first defense against Ilian Inahanchi, also in Bangkok. It was Pit Dam's first ever loss in one super series. It was also his first ever loss to a non-Thai. Inside leg kick from Rodtang. There will come a point, well, there always has, where Rodtang, like a grenade, decides to pull the pin and explode on his opponent. We've seen him do it in pretty much every contest he's been in so far here at One Super Series. Feels them out. There comes a point where he decides that's it. He pulls the pin. And he goes.
And when he does, it's hellacious. Both men very familiar with each other. They know all the tricks, Mitch, that each other presents.
Yeah, I think the secrets to success in this match can be found in their past matchups. In the first match, Petdam beautifully established himself in that jab. He really kept that distance and set up that big left kick, and that's how he was able to secure a victory the first time. But in the second match, Rodtang kept that pressure on and never stopped, letting those hands go at every single opportunity.
Both men first competed as 8-year-olds. For Rodtang, it was at a temple fair in southern Thailand. Did so in only 2 weeks training. Went on to win his first 9 matches in a row. Nice backing up left hand there from Petdam. Rodtang didn't like it, comes forward immediately. They clinch and Rodtang throws some knees. Referee Cal Klum breaks them. Rodtang had a banner year in 2019, went 8-0. Probing jabs from Petdam. Throws that half side kick, half front kick off the lead leg. Rodtang edging forward. Good outside leg kick from Rodtang. Tried to return with the high kick to Petdam. And back to the jab. Those long arms of Petdam, Pet India Academy. He just watched his stablemate, his good friend Pip Morricott, retain the world featherweight title. How he would love to bring the flyweight title to the fabled Pip India Academy. Rodtang will want to back him into the corner, put him against the ropes, but Pip Dam turns him nicely. Referee breaks the Mitch.
You can see Petdam does a good job inside that clinch. He's got those long arms that can wrap around the head of Rodtang. But you can see Rodtang is not giving him an inch. He keeps pushing forward, trying to keep him in that boxing range.
Nice leg kick there from Rodtang. Petdam sitting behind the jab, goes down to the legs. Rodtang, four punch combination, crossing elbow off the left. He gets on the inside and he explodes Rodtang. And that's the liver shot, the one that he hurt Jonathan Haggerty with. The devastating liver shots of Rodtang, the way he dips down, drives the knuckles of the left hand between the 9th and 10th ribs, impacts that vagus nerve, and can close the whole body down. You talk to athletes who have been knocked down or knocked out with a liver shot, and they'll tell you it's the most painful way to get knocked out. Usually a delayed reaction. The shot hits, there's a split second, and then you go down. Very hard to get up. Rodtang, a master at the liver shot. Nice hook there from Rodtang. Misses with the right hand. Looping punches from the tank. High kick from Rodtang. The mercury rising now with Rodtang. What does Petdam need to do here, Dragon?
He's got to be careful with that body shot. I was talking to Jonathan Haggerty, and Haggerty was saying how Rodtang's body punches feel like he was having rocks thrown at his body. The tank starts rolling, and it's really hard to slow him down. But if anybody can do it, it's the accurate power striker that is Petdam.
Petdam needs to employ those knees, needs to employ those round kicks off the back leg. Petdam inching close. For the elbows, throws one off the left arm there. Rodtang hunts for the uppercut. They clinch against the ropes. Referee Cal Klum breaks them. Rodtang quickly glancing towards his corner. Wants to go to the body of Petdam. Look for the hooks here of Rodtang as he comes forward. There's the hooking punch from the champion. Double forearms guard against the round kick. Goes downstairs on Petdam. Petdam always brings a different hairstyle into the ring. Actually, in preparation for this one, before he went to the barber, he asked the fans. He said, I'll let the fans vote on what hairstyle I should have. And there is the result. I think it's the lightning bolt. That was the one that I voted for, Mitch.
It's a very slick hairstyle. It's almost normal looking. But he's got to be more active. He needs to channel that inner lightning bolt and start putting things together. Because in that first match at Rajdhaman Stadium, he was so successful at using that jab and firing off that rear leg roundhouse. But he was a lot more active. He was throwing a lot more shots. He's allowing Rodtang to walk him down, get him, to kind of corner him up against the ropes, and then he's starting to tee off on the hands. Pet Dam's got to be more active, like this.
Pet Dam trying to break down the right forearm of Rodtang. Break down the arm, force Rodtang to drop that arm, then come over the top and loop the shoot around the back of the neck. Gets out of danger there, off the ropes. You don't want to be pressed against the ropes with Rodtang in 4 ounce gloves. Now they can jump chart for the knees. Rodtang gets one off the right leg, swings it in nicely again off the right leg, just below the waist. Referee Kalklund breaks them. Under a minute remaining, third of five. Rodtang again with a power salvo. Pet Dam misses the head kick. Rodtang ties him up, clinches around the waist. Referee has to pry them apart. The intense rivalry between these two. A war of words over social media. A couple of weeks ago, with Rodtang saying that his biggest fear in this contest was that Pet Dam would run away from him. He caught him with a beautiful left hand a couple of moments ago. Pet Dam did a quick count of his teeth. Got to get out of the corner here, though, as Rodtang turns up the aggressive meter once again. This is another good round for Rodtang, Mitch.
Yeah, that left hand is starting to test the chin of Pet Dam. Pet Dam's got to be very careful, because that's the second time that he's been wobbled by that nice left hook that Rodtang's starting to throw.
67.4% tipping a Rodtang win, 32.6% tipping a Pet Dam win. An overwhelming 63% of fans were tipping that both Pet Morakot and Rodtang would retain their world titles tonight in Bangkok. Left hook again from Rodtang. There's the uppercut. Went higher than my cholesterol. Elbow there from Pet Dam. Rodtang is frightening in these 4 ounce gloves. The way he loops these punches, pure Muay Mat style. Of Rodtang Wangnod. Now goes downstairs to the legs. Leans back like Fat Joe, evades the high kick. Pet Dam needs to change it up a little here. Catch and counter, employing the same technique that his stablemate Pet Morakot used effectively against Jodson Klein. Inside leg kick from Rodtang. But has Rodtang worked out Pet Dam? Is there anything different, Mitch, you think that Pet Dam can show Rodtang? Or does Rodtang just have it figured out?
See, this style here where he starts to back up, he starts to put that jab out, and he starts to throw that hand, but immediately, Rodtang starts to jump all over him. He doesn't give him that space to breathe. He doesn't give him that opportunity to create that movement and keep that space. Pet Dam has to keep moving. He cannot get sucked into a firefight with Rodtang. Rodtang wants that. He wants those animalistic brawls to just stand there toe-to-toe and start throwing those hands. Pet Dam has to use his head. He's got to stay on his bicycle and keep moving.
It's so true, Mitch. You can't go inside a phone booth with Rodtang. You've got to stay on the outside. You've got to work the kicks both to the legs, to the body, to the head. Step through knees. If Rodtang comes in, clip him with the elbow. But it's easy for us to say, when you're in there against the tank, when you're in there against the world champion, the young world champion, who's had 262 career wins, it's not easy. And Pet Dam is finding it very difficult again here in the fourth round. Round kick there from Pet Dam, tucks it under the right arm. Rodtang choosing his moments now. Good jab from Pet Dam. There's the elbow as Rodtang came in. That's what Pet Dam's got to do. Try and open a cut on Rodtang. Give yourself a target. Paint it on Rodtang's face, on his forehead. Something to aim at. Something to open up. Rodtang, right hand cocked and ready. In orthodox stance here, Rodtang. Southpaw stance on Pet Dam. Rodtang not overexerting himself. He also knows the countering abilities of Pet Dam. peppering jabs. There's the round kick from Pit Dan. That had some nasty power, but so too that right hand. Did you see the sweat fly off the brow of Pit Dan into the ringside observers? Left hook, overhand right, double overhand right there from Rodtang. Rodtang with a high right roundhouse. But you see Pit Dan trying to mix it up now, trying to get his tempo, trying to get his rhythm, and trying to up the power stakes. Rodtang doesn't seem phased. What can phase this powerful young man, this powerful young world champion? One of 10 children, the son of rubber tree workers. His parents never earned a wage. They only got compensated by how much they could tap from rubber trees. Grew up in poverty, Rodtang, but now finds himself at the very top of the world. Earlier on tonight, his girlfriend, Stan Fairtex, getting a quick win over Sunisa Ceesay. Will the power couple of the martial arts world both prevail tonight? And he just dumps Pit Dam to the canvas like yesterday's garbage. Pit Dam straight back to his feet, but here was Rodtang again coming over the top. Pit Dam with the firing kicks. Rodtang gets on the inside. He's just a monster, Mitch. He's an absolute Muay Thai monster, a Muay Mutt monster.
Yeah, we're seeing, but it's kind of a different strategy from, you know, Rodtang. He's not just this, you know, animalistic brawler who just walks forward throwing heavy shots. He's actually a technician as well. He can pick you apart and shut you down in your own game. And he is doing just enough to outscore Pit Dam in most of these exchanges and looking brilliant along the way.
The big question here, what does Pit Dam do with 60 seconds remaining to turn the tide, to swing the pendulum? Because everything Pit Dam has done has not worked for him the way he'd wanted to. Almost went through the ropes there. It has been a sensational contest. The guts and intestinal fortitude from Pit Dam Pet India Academy in Southport starts. Continually coming forward, though, is Rodtang Chipwangmon, the champion. And Pit Dam's got to wonder, can I find something in 30 seconds? Have I got a Hail Mary shot? Have I got one big round kick left? Maybe a question mark kick that can somehow loop its way over the gloves, over the shoulder of Rodtang, and find his jaw, find his neck, find his carotid artery. Round kick off the left, goes to the body, and Rodtang just walks away from it. We are going down to the judges in Bangkok. A thrilling main event. Rodtang, a couple of final salvos. Tremendous performance from two amazing athletes. But was it enough or too little too late? Look at the power here and the accuracy. Rocks the head back of Pit Dam. Was a beauty. Sweat just flew off his brow. Cracking round kick to the ribs there, the catch and the attempted sweep, and it worked nicely to upend Pit Dam. Will Rodtang retain the title and get career win number 263? What do you think, Dragon?
Yeah, he just did his game plan perfectly executed. He was able to keep Pit Dam stationary by keeping him up against the ropes and just teeing off on him.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner. And still one Super Series Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion, Rodtang Chipwangmon.
He usually throws at 40% of significant strikes to the head, Rodtang, except against Pit Dam. He went 74% on that night.
See, this is vintage Rodtang right here. He's trying to corner Khalilov and put hands on him. Khalilov believes he would have the advantage in boxing combinations. And he wants to throw a lot of heavy hands. But I would imagine he's got a height advantage. He might want to keep that reach, keep moving, utilize the jab.
Make no doubt about it, folks. If Khalilov finds a way to beat Rodtang, it will be a major, major upset. Body shot to head there from Rodtang. Good cover up though, and the counters. Nice return from Khalilov.
Some showboating here from Rodtang, and that means Khalilov caught him. Good jab from Khalilov.
You can see on these exchanges here, though, each time that Khalilov is thrown, Rodtang is able to return with 2 to 3 pieces at a time. There's definitely a speed difference here.
Again, Rodtang cuts off the movement of Khalilov. Khalilov to the lead outside thigh. Good check there from Rodtang. Stiff left hook.
That's what Khalilov needs to be careful of, standing at this range. This is where Rodtang just overwhelms people, especially with those hooking shots when he goes to the body and then he starts to go up top once he has you opened up.
If Rodtang wins tonight, he's already called out the winner of tonight's main event, be it Inahachi or Superlek, to challenge for the Flyweight Kickboxing World title. Catch an attempted counter there from Khalilov. Khalilov already surviving a lot longer than many people thought. Once again, an overwhelming 96% of fans tipping a win for Rodtang, 81% saying via knockout. It is the most lopsided prediction in one Super App history. Left hand there from Rodtang. Left to right, doubles up on the right. The old 3-2 combination. Back to center circle. The impact of those gloves.
Nice left hand landed by Rodtang. His jabs are heavy. I can't even, he just throws everything with power.
Khalilov has got to keep that lead hand tight because Rodtang is going to eventually find a home for that lead left hook there.
If Khalilov gets out of the first round, having landed a couple of punches on Rodtang, it should do wonders for his confidence. Circling both ways and Rodtang calling him forward, saying, come on!
Yeah, I don't know if just getting past the first round is going to do wonders for his confidence, because once you feel Rodtang's power, it starts to leave, that confidence just starts to leave your body.
Rodtang will turn up the aggressor meter. There's the hooks. Hook to leg kick. The classic Rodtang combination. Checks the low kick. Rodtang, a cool attack because he is continually rolling forward on opponents.
I'm impressed with Khalilov here too. He's hit another gear in the second round coming out.
Said he'd have the speed over Rodtang. Eats a right hand there. Clinch, knees. Got to be offensive in the clinch, never defensive under kickboxing rules.
You know, Rodtang gets visibly upset when people don't stand and trade with him, but you cannot fall into that trap. You've got to keep moving. You've got to stick, and then you've got to move. You cannot sit there and trade shots with Rodtang. Jim Wong Nan.
Stop! Break!
Nice lead uppercut there. As he closed the distance, he just landed a beautiful sweet uppercut.
Rodtang marching forward, outside leg kicks from both men. Khalilov dropping that. Left glove a little low though. Gotta be careful. As much as Rodtang is hooking off the left hand, he can also hook off the right, believe me.
Maybe I was wrong. Khalilov is having a much better round here in the second. He's got to just keep this volume up, but he cannot allow him to get backed up like this. He cannot get his back up against that wall. This is what Rodtang does best. He pressures you up against the wall and he freezes you there.
Rodtang trying to cut off the movement of Khalilov. Goes to the inside thigh. Khalilov, nice quarter turn. Gets back to center circle. That was well done from Khalilov. A little hematoma over the left eye. Nothing too serious though on Tagir Khalilov. Circling away from Rodtang's left side. Again goes that distance. Body shot from Rodtang. Right hand didn't connect. Khalilov smiling at Rodtang. Maybe trying to get inside Rodtang's mind. Maybe trying to frustrate Rodtang and open him up to a counter.
Look at the inside of that left leg of Khalilov. And the outside, for that matter. You can see the work that Rodtang's put on it.
It is red raw, but Khalilov is still here and still giving a pretty decent account of himself.
He's doing much better in this round. He's landing shots, you know, but you got to wonder, is that redness on his legs going to count as superficial damage, Rich?
It will. It'll add up in the superficial damage category. But until it actually changes something in his stance or style, switches his lead or something like that, it hasn't accumulated to something more significant than superficial.
It's again.
I honestly think another confidence boosting round for Khalilov. He's not going to win the round on my scorecard, but he's going to go into the third with Rodtang. It's a place a lot of people don't get to. Is it Rodtang playing to the judges almost?
Maybe, but I think he's playing more to the psychology of Khalilov.
And psychology, Khalilov's been working his mind tricks too. He's been smiling at Rodtang. Very few people smile at Rodtang. Trying to get inside Rodtang's mind, trying to frustrate Rodtang. Maybe hoping Rodtang will open up and give an opening to Khalilov. Now you see Rodtang turning up the pressure. Here comes the volume. Here comes the power of the tank, of the Iron Man.
Rodtang's hunt for that finish.
Rodtang just hit another gear.
You hear Rodtang grunting as he lands those hooks. Every time, back to the body, goes upstairs. This is classic Rodtang, and look at Khalilov playing the mind game, saying, come on, you've got to do better than that. You're Rodtang.
Well, I'll tell you what, Khalilov has lived up to his word. He said that he wasn't afraid of Rodtang's power, and he's in the middle of round three and taunting him.
But you can see the way that Rodtang cuts the corner off, and he forces Khalilov to circle to his power side. He's circling him right into that big right hand and those leg kicks.
Don't forget, a win here for Rodtang has already called out the main event winner tonight, be it Inahachi or Superlek. Whoever's the champion at the end of tonight, Rodtang says he wants them next for the world kickboxing title. He's already the world Muay Thai champion of one super series. Continually coming forward. But Khalilov is still here, defying the critics, defying the fans. Spinning back fist from Khalilov. How do you do? What audacity. In the final round from Khalilov to throw a spinning back fist against Rodtang.
I think this is a great debut for Tagir Khalilov. Teeing off. Look at Rodtang. Rodtang. What a show.
Unaffected. I love the showboating from Rodtang, but keep in mind, those are punches landing.
Score.
And they're scoring.
Reminiscent of when Mark Hunt and Ray Seppo went at it. Dropping their hands, allowing the other to tee off.
Man, I'd like to see Khalilov go up high with a head kick the next time Rodtang does that. You can't just punch him like that. He's got such an iron chin. Iron man.
And Rodtang still cannot drop Tagir Khalilov. Khalilov 22 wins. Rodtang 265 wins. And Khalilov's about to go the distance with the mighty Rodtang. Final 10 seconds. Rodtang still trying to drop it. Khalilov nods, still standing. Still firing. Tremendous. Rodtang will take the victory. There's no doubt about that whatsoever. But Khalilov may take a personal victory.
Despite that's a moral victory.
1% of fans who thought he'd get knocked out.
That is a total moral victory for Tagir Khalilov. He was in it every step of the way. He wasn't even wobbled. He wasn't knocked down. He was egging on. There he is, landing a spinning back fist, putting on a show against one of the very best inside one series. But look at Rodtang.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the red corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision from the red corner, Rodtang.
Probing with the inside and outside, thigh kicks early. Counter right hand there from Mini T, the Australian in the gray. Get down,
I like that Rodtang lead hook that he throws. He throws it almost instead of a jab, he likes to throw that power lead hook. You can see Mini T's trying to paw down the rear hand of Rodtang so he can land that right there. These styles are very similar from these two. But it's that experience advantage that Rodtang has.
Watch a replay of this event in VR in the Venues app on Oculus Quest this Saturday at 8 p.m. Eastern. Sakyat tattoo on the back there of Mini T. Fakes the right hand of the Australian. You see the Prajed armbands around the biceps of Rodtang. Traditionally, they were made by tearing a piece of a mother's sarong and wrapping it around her son's arm for good luck on the battlefield. It's part of a very old Thai tradition that has carried into modern Muay Thai.
Mini T was actually born in Thailand before he transferred over to Australia.
Coming close with that counter right hand is Mini T, Danial Williams. Patient start here from Rodtang.
This is a patient start, but you can tell Rodtang came out immediately and does what Rodtang does. He started taking control of that circle and moving forward.
Showing no signs of being intimidated, Danial Williams. The overwhelming reputation of Rodtang, who is the one Super Series world champion. Fake there from Williams. Rodtang, wary of that right hand, which Williams pulls off very quickly and with accuracy. Looks for the outside lead thigh. Good cutting, half front kick, half side kick there, and a nice one again from Rodtang. Goes downstairs. Corner of Danial Williams are telling him to fight long, and that's what he does. Down the center corridor, long leaping hook there. They want to try and keep Rodtang at the end of Daniel's punches.
Williams is doing a good job of closing that distance, and you can see how Rodtang's utilizing that push kick to try to keep Danial Williams from coming forward.
Yeah, I'll tell you, but Daniel has found a home for that right hand a couple times now on Rodtang's chin.
It would be a massive upset if Danial Williams can beat Rodtang Wang Nan. Rodtang's been on this incredible streak, incredible tear. The biggest winning streak in one Super Series. Outside leg kick from the tack. Cross out the jack. Confidence building opening round, I feel, here for the Australian Mini T Danial Williams as we end the opener. It was an unfamiliar slow start from Rodtang in the opening round.
This is typically where we see Rodtang level up and shift gears. And he starts to put a little bit more fire behind his shots.
Inside leg to that. Femoral profunda there. And another one from Rodtang. Goes to the inside leg a third time.
You can hear those leg kicks landing from the booth here.
One way to slow down the boxing of your opponent is to kick the legs, because every good punch begins from the bottom of the feet and works its way up the body until it exits out of the fist. So if you can kick the legs, you can effectively slow down the boxing. And we know the boxing was effective of Danial Williams in the first round. As Rich noted, he did almost find the target with the right hand. And there's a nice little turning left hook, almost a gazelle punch there from Mini T.
I think that left hook from Rodtang just hurt Danial Williams there.
Another one from Rodtang. A mandible rally. Oh, the big kibosh! Mini T went down. The left hook from Rodtang.
Mitch called it. This is when Rodtang always switches to another gear in the second round.
Danial Williams says he's okay to go on, but the cobwebs are still there. And here comes Rodtang. This is danger now for Williams. Spinning back elbow from Mini T. The Australian's got a long time to survive this round with Rodtang on the front foot. Another left hook. Overhand elbow, crossing elbow, uppercut elbow. The full Muay Thai repertoire here from Rodtang.
A lot of people try to run from Rodtang, but Mini T is not backing down, but he's got to move.
Mini T staying inside the phone booth, but he's got to get out of danger. Beautiful teep kick to the midsection of the Australian.
Yeah, out comes the Iron Man now. Danial T has got to start moving because that range is lighting him up.
These elbows, the most dangerous weapon in Muay Thai. Rodtang consistently on the front foot, uppercut elbow. Mini T's cut over the left eye. Rodtang has lit him up here in the second round.
Yeah, you can tell Rodtang there got a little emotional after he caught that knockdown and was getting a little overzealous for the knockout, but now he's kind of composed himself and he's really starting to pick his shots intelligently with those elbows.
We usually see Rodtang take opponents apart with his hands. Tonight, though, he's looking for the elbow knockout. Look at the slice and dice and fillet Williams. But Williams is not prepared to wave the white flag here, Dragon.
Yeah, he is standing in the pocket, not changing his game, not running. Still willing to go toe-to-toe.
Stiff right hand on the inside there from Mini T. Rodtang sticks a foot in his face. What a tremendous round for Rodtang. He'll take it 10-8 on the judges' scorecard following that knockdown. Round to cover now for Mini T. He needs a knockdown on Rodtang to have any hopes here. And you know what, Rich, as you said, he's got heat in the hands, has the Australian. If Rodtang makes a mistake, if Rodtang gets lazy, Williams can expose him.
Especially with these 4-ounce gloves. That's one thing that the fans got to keep in mind here is they're not using the big gloves. This is Muay Thai with 4-ounce gloves. And I love the way Mini T just started out this round aggressively.
How's this from Mini T now with the elbows? We saw a jumping downward elbow, a cranium cracker earlier on. There's a two-punch combination from the Aussie. Rodtang does a quick count of his teeth. Mini T's not going to go anywhere quietly. A crossing elbow from Mini T.
Hats off to the competition team for making this matchup because they picked a perfect opponent for Rodtang. Mini T is in this, ladies and gentlemen.
Danial Williams goes to the outside back thigh of Rodtang. Rodtang in southpaw start. Overhand right there from Williams. Guts and intestinal fortitude on the Aussie. Body shot, belly button through the back. Misses with the left. You can hear the heavy breathing of Williams, and he's still inside that phone booth, still trading with Rodtang. Doesn't want to take a backward step. My word, this is a game plan we never see anyone in play against Rodtang.
No, he is definitely exchanging inside that pocket and testing the chin of Rodtang. But Rodtang's doing a good job of keeping his head off the center line and just overwhelming Daniel with a lot of these shots.
Yeah, you know, this break here was actually called for by Rodtang. He looked at the ref and said, hey, I have blood on me. Like, let's get this stuff wiped off.
So the doctor doing a quick inspection of our athletes here, making sure everything is okay, get them wiped off, and we'll throw down again. This is the third round of an amazing match in which Daniel Williams was dropped by Rodtang in the second round, but has powered back here in the third round, and I'm telling you, he can give Rodtang some problems if Rodtang's not careful. Overhand right from Rodtang. Williams goes to the left. Looks for a downward elbow. The collarbone is the target. Overhand elbows from both.
Nice little fake, the push kick and the late into jab from Rodtang as he switched stances to come forward. I like the diversity of elbows coming from Mini T though.
Beautiful uppercut elbow off the right arm from Rodtang and a crossing elbow, sock to it, it's known as in Muay Thai. Another crossing elbow, and attack his ear off, the old Van Gogh technique. Body shot. You hear the connection on some of these blows with the 4-ounce gloves. It is frightening, Rich.
Yeah, and you can see that when Mini T landed that shot on Rodtang, he did what Rodtang does. He said, no, I don't like that. And he go ahead and put his hands down and waiting for another one.
Rodtang's cut. It looks like a cut on the hairline of Rodtang.
Who would have thought Mini T would be in this match 30 seconds to go playing this game with Rodtang? Standing there toe-to-toe.
At yesterday's press conference, Danial Williams said, I want to make my name worldwide against Rodtang. He is certainly doing that. What a performance from the Australian. He's got to think, though, what would have happened if he hadn't have got dropped in the second round. It's been a great third round for Mini T. And look at the respect, the integrity, the honor of these two martial arts warriors. Tremendous contest, back and forth battle that was competed inside the proverbial phone booth for three rounds solid.
Yeah, look at Mini T though, moving off. Creating the opening and then answering back, but Rodtang did all the right things, keeping his guard nice and tight, not taking too much damage, absorbing these shots, but then connecting on opportunities like that. Look at that beautiful fake. That's what I was talking about. Opened up with the push kick, faked it, and then came right across the step cross jab. Just a beautiful display of Muay Thai from Rodtang Jim Wong Nong.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Rodtang.